Thank you so much for inviting me to the European Bifurcation Club. This is the title of my talk, Local Fluid Dynamics in Patients with Bifurcated Coronary Lesions Undergoing PCI. These are my disclosures. This is the design of a virtual clinical trial we ran to compare different bifurcation stenting techniques. We have 120 patient-specific bifurcations covering the entire spectrum of bifurcation angles and disease complexity. Each bifurcation is computationally stented with four different techniques, one stent technique or two stent techniques, glot, decay, crash, tap. Then for every bifurcation stenting technique, we calculate biomechanical factors like fluid and solid shear stresses, fluid stresses, as well as stent morphometry parameters like strata position, expansion, and so on. And then we create an atlas, essentially, of bifurcation anatomies and stent simulations. The whole goal of this virtual clinical trial is to identify groups of bifurcations which are best treated with specific stenting techniques. Let me get into the specifics of this study. This is the platform, the computational stent platform we use to simulate computationally those techniques. We start with merging angiography with OCT to 3D reconstruct the bifurcations. Then we assign plaque-specific material properties coming from OCT. We enter in the system and the platform realistic stent designs and balloons. We run the simulations, the computational simulations of four different techniques as I described. And then the outcomes of the platform of the study is stent morphometry as well as stent biomechanics. A close-up of our methods here, the reconstruction of the lumen, then meshing of the lumen, and also assignment of realistic plaque stiffness. We identify by OCT the configuration, distribution of different plaque constituents in the 3D reconstructed wall, and then we translate this to patient-specific plaque stiffness. Here you see different OCT frames along the reconstructed wall and how they correlate with patient-specific wall stiffness. Then each anatomy is stented computationally with four different techniques, provisional, tap, culotte, and decay crash. Following the steps, we published in our recent paper, white paper, by the EBC. This is the provisional TM protrusion with a metallic neocarina. Again, the only thing that changes in each bifurcation anatomy is a stenting technique. Culotte and decay crash. Then, for each anatomy, for every technique, we calculate with CFD the flow distribution across the stented segment. And you can see here the flow distribution with the provisional technique, with the TM protrusion, clot, and decay crash. You appreciate the flow acceleration across the stented segment with a diastole. Also, we calculate the shear stress distribution across the stented segment. Again, we talk about the same anatomy, the same bifurcation anatomy, stented with computationally with four different techniques so that we can compare apples to apples and head-to-head comparison between different techniques. And then we can have like a bigger close-up, focus on the strut level. Here you can see in a decay crash technique, the distribution of shear stress on the main vessel, side branch, at the carina, you see the flow acceleration around the stent struts at the carina with diastole. Even we can see the crushed part of the stent, this double-layer stent at the distal main vessel close to the side branch ostium. Also, we have the opportunity to cut across different locations of the stented segments and get to see how the flow is distributed there as well. Each bifurcation anatomy then is assigned different zones which cover all the area from the very proximal segment to the distal side branch, distal main vessel. And in each zone, for every bifurcation technique, we calculate biomechanical forces and factors and stent morphometry parameters. This way, we have the opportunity to compare head-to-head different bifurcation techniques in every in the same bifurcation geometry in the same particular zone. And this information is very important because it can give us the opportunity to identify what is the technique, the stenting technique that gives us the best performance, the most favorable performance in an individual bifurcation anatomy. Not only we compare different stent techniques, but also we compare different post-dilatation techniques like POT versus kissing. That's a study which the data we use come from the PROPOT study. where 120 bifurcation lesions coming from patients were post-dilated either with POT or kissing balloon inflation, 60 with POT, 60 with KVI. Using our sophisticated algorithms, we 3D reconstruct the implanted stents using OCT. And then here is an example of the 3D reconstructed stent by OCT in a patient with a POT and a patient who had post-dilatation with KVI. Again, those are patients who had one stent technique post-dilated with either POT or KVI. And then we calculate the flow distribution, the shear stress in POT versus KVI. Here we talk about different patients, different geometries, but definitely we have the opportunity to compare the flow distribution between two different post-dilatation techniques. So with that, I would like to thank our funding for, sources, for funding from federal resources, from industry and philanthropy. A big thank to my group, the world-class engineers, MDs, and vascular biologists who are behind all those sophisticated studies. And I would like to open this to discussion. Thank you for your attention.